Hello everyone, welcome to the first PUC online classes. In today's session of a first PUC class, let us discuss about the calculation of mean. I am Suma, economics lecturer. So in our previous session, we understood about the averages. In this fifth lesson of part A, that is statistics for economics, under the fifth lesson measure of central tendency, we will today learn about the calculation of mean. So before we move towards the calculation of mean, let us understand three important basic concepts of the series. There are three types of groups of numbers and they are called as the series. The first one is individual series. In this individual series, there are only frequencies are given, and based on those frequencies we have to calculate the mean, median and mode. So this includes only the numbers, certain numbers. We have to calculate the mean, median and mode using this. In the second one, we learn about discrete series. Here, it is one which has both classes as well as frequencies. So it is a class with frequency. So classes are like this. They are individual. They are not continuous. They are only individual numbers, and as against them there are the numbers or frequencies. Using these classes and frequencies, we calculate both. We calculate mean, median and mode. So the third one is continuous series. Continuous series are those in which the classes are in continuous. They are mentioned as class intervals here. So the continuity of the numbers can be seen here. For example, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, like that it goes on. A continuous series one is one which has classes, continuous classes and also frequencies. So with these three types of the classes and frequencies, we have to calculate the important averages, statistical averages, and they are the mean, median and mode. So now let us calculate the mean for all the three types of series. The first one is individual series, second one is the discrete series, and the third one is continuous series. So first let us calculate the mean for the individual series. The problem will be asked like this: calculate mean using the following data. So here they have given 10 different numbers. So we have to consider this. So we should take the total of this and we have to divide it by the numbers. So the total of all these numbers is 734. So the sigma x is 734. At first, let us calculate the mean using the direct method. For individual series, we are calculating the mean using direct method. The formula is x bar, that is mean is denoted by x bar. So mean equals sigma x by n, that is here the total of this of these 10 values is 734. So 734 divided by 10, because we have 10 numbers here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So numbers, totally 10 numbers are there. So that n is 10, that is the number of values, and the sigma x, the total, sum total of all these 10 numbers is 734. 734 divided by 10 is 73.4. So for the same problem, we can calculate the mean using shortcut method. So now let us see about the calculation of mean using the shortcut method. So to calculate the mean through shortcut method, we have to take one number belonging to this series or any number which is between this range. We have here taken as 75. So the assumed mean is 75. 75 is not here in this series, but any number between these numbers. So 75 we have taken. It is just an assumed mean. It is not given in the sum. So from 75 we deduct or we see the difference between these numbers individually with the assumed mean. So 75 minus 65 is minus 10, because here you can see 65 is the first class here, first number. So 65 minus 75 here, 75 is more than 65, so it is minus 10. So we have taken the minus 10. So 75 minus 68 is minus 07. 75 minus 76 here, this number is more than the assumed mean. So 76, so number 1, it is increased by 1 number. So we have got plus 1. So 80 is 75 plus 5, 80. And 82, 75 plus 7, 82. 75 plus 12, that is the difference between 87 and 75 is 12. The difference between 69 and 75 is 6, but here 75 is more than 69, so we have used the minus, negative sign. And the 75 minus 74 is again minus 1, and the difference between 78 and 75 is 03, and the difference between 81 and 75 is 6. So when once this is done, we will calculate, we will take the sum totals of all the negative signs and the positive signs. So the total of negative signs is here 10, 10 plus 7, 17, 17 plus 6, 23, 23 plus 1 is 24. So the total of all the negative values is minus 24. So now let us see about the total of all the positive values. So here 1 is there, 1 plus 5 is 6, 6 plus 7 is 13, 13 plus 12 is 25, 25 plus 3 is 28, 28 plus 6 is 34. So when we add all the positive values, it comes to plus 34, that is the total of all the positive values is 34. So 34 minus 24 is 10. So here the positive number is higher than the negative values total. So therefore the difference between the positive values and the negative values is 10. So sigma dx is 10. So using the shortcut method, now let us calculate the mean for individual series. The formula for calculating mean through shortcut method is x bar equals a plus sigma dx divided by n, the total numbers. So 75 is the assumed mean. Here we have taken 75 as assumed mean. So assumed mean plus sigma dx divided by the total numbers. So 75 plus 10, that is here we have got the difference between the positive values and the negative values as 10. So that 10 is written here, and the total numbers are 10. So when we are calculating the mean through shortcut method, the formula is x bar equals a plus sigma dx by n. So the assumed mean, a is assumed mean, that is here 75, and 75 plus sigma dx. Sigma dx is the difference between the positive values and the negative values. So positive values are 34 and negative values are here minus 24. So here positive values are higher than the negative values. So we have got a positive number, that is plus 10. So 10 is written here, and it is divided by total number. The total numbers are 10. So 10 divided by 10 is 1. So assumed mean is 75 plus sigma dx by n. Sigma dx is 10 divided by 10. So 10 ones are 10. So 75 plus 1 is 76. So here the mean through shortcut method for this individual series is 76. So now let us calculate the mean for the discrete series under both direct method as well as shortcut method. So for discrete series, the questions will be like this. Calculate the mean for the following data. So in the question itself, they'll give both X and F, the class and frequencies. Here the classes are individual numbers. So now we have to put these horizontal numbers into vertical numbers. So the answer for this is, we'll write the class as 4, 7, 8, 10, 12 and 14. 4, 7, 8, 10, 12 and 14. And the frequencies are written in front of them or against them respectively. So the total value of the frequencies is 70. So when we add all the frequencies, we obtain 70. So after that, we have to get the fx, that is, we have to multiply these two. So the formula for calculating the mean for discrete series under direct method is mean equals sigma fx by n. So when we multiply these two, we obtain the fx. 4 6 are 24, 7 8 are 56, 8 10 are 80, 10 12 are 120, and 12 18 are 216, 14 16 are 224. The sum total of these fx numbers is sigma fx and it comes to 720. So the formula is x bar equals sigma fx by n, that is 720 by 70. 720 divided by 70 is 10.28. So now let us calculate the mean for this discrete series using shortcut method. For the calculation of the mean using the shortcut method for discrete series, we have to again calculate the dx, because the formula is a plus fdx by n. So dx is the deviation of x. So here again we will take a number as assumed mean, and here we have taken 10 as the assumed mean. So x minus a, here the deviation is x minus a, that is, let us write the difference between this number, that is x, and the assumed mean. The assumed mean is 10. 10 minus 4 is minus 6. Difference between 7 and 10 is minus 3. Difference between 8 and 10 is minus 2. Difference between 10 and 10 is 0. Difference between 12 and 10 is plus 2, because here 12, the number, that is the x, is higher than the assumed mean, so positive number. Then 14, the difference between 14 and 10 is plus 4. Again here the value of the x is higher than the assumed mean, so positive number. Now we have obtained the dx, but for the formula we have to calculate fdx. So we should multiply this dx with the frequencies. So 6 6 are 36. Since here we have the minus symbol or minus sign, here also we have to write the negative sign. So 8 3 is 24, minus 3, so minus 24. 10 2 is 20, since it is minus 2, it is minus 20. So 12 0 is 0, and 18 2 is 36, 16 4 is 64. So when we add the positive values, we obtain 94, and the negative values, we obtain minus 80. So the total value of the negative signs is minus 80, and the total value of the positive signs is 94. So 94 minus 80 is plus 14, because the plus value is higher than the minus value. So now let's again put the formula for this. A plus fdx by n. A is the assumed mean, that here we have taken 10 as the assumed mean. So we'll write 10 here, plus 14. That is the value we obtained here, that is fdx is 14. We obtained the fdx by deducting the positive minus value from the positive values or the plus values. So the fdx is 14 divided by n, that is n value is 70.
So 10 plus 14 by 70. When 14 is divided by 70, we obtain 0.2. So assumed mean is already given here, 10. So 10 plus 02 is 10.2. So both here under direct method and the assumed mean method, we obtained almost the same answer. I wish to conclude this session with the thought for the day. The thought for today is, the goal of meditation is not to control your thoughts, but it is to stop letting them control you. Since childhood, many of us practice meditating. It enhances our concentration power and helps in concentrate on our studies. So the goal of meditation is not known to many people. The objective of the meditation is not known to many of us. The goal is, it is not to control your thoughts. It is to stop letting them control you, because each and every second different thoughts will enter our mind and pass through it. We have to see that these thoughts that enter our mind should not control us. Instead, we should stop letting them control us. So these thoughts should not be allowed to control us, because when all the thoughts that pass through our mind take our mind into their control, it becomes difficult to handle the situations at some times. Therefore, it is to stop these thoughts letting them control us. So with this, I conclude this session. Thank you.